Today I'm going to be reviewing the novel The Last Empress. It's a historical novel by An Chi-min, and it tells the story of Dowager Empress Cixi and how she ruled for her son and then her nephew. And it goes until the age of 27, when she's 27, and then ends pretty much at her death in 1908. And to be perfectly honest, I didn't care for this book. It just didn't hold my interest like other books have. The writing style, it seemed more like a actual history book than a historical novel. And it kind of makes me mad because I ordered this book because it was something different. Because I usually don't read about Imperial China. I usually read about Western royalty. And so when I ordered this book and I came in, I was very excited about it was something new that I was going to read. And I really wanted to start it, and then as I started it, it took me a while to finish it, and it took me a lot to get me to keep reading the book, and it read more like a history book, and I didn't really connect with a lot of the characters in the book. It was more, okay, that character did this, and I didn't really feel, like when some of the characters died, I didn't really feel like I was connected to them, and that's kind of sad, because I was really looking forward to this book, and they could have done so much. The author could have done so much. And one thing I found particularly that kind of put me off was it starts out when Cixi is 27, and it starts off when the emperor, not her son, but the son's father, dies. And so, we didn't really get to see her struggle to gain power and to gain prestige as a concubine. Because she started out as really a low-ranking concubine. And she gives birth to a son, so that elevates her status. And I would have loved to see that story of her kind of becoming, you know, the empress, or becoming the dowager empress and becoming the concubine. That would have been a lot more interesting, I think, in her trying to claw her way to power and things of that nature. But it starts out right at her death, which was very, right at his death, I'm sorry, at his death. And so I found that very strange. And one redeeming quality of the book is I found it interesting how they decided the emperor, because it's different than Western circles and Western royalty. You have to have a little bit of legitimacy. It's not like how they do in England or other places. As long as you have some royalty, you were able to, you know, inherit the throne, which is a lot different than other countries. But besides that, it took a very long time to finish. And I didn't like that. Because I want to be, you know, you want to be invested in the story. But I really wasn't. And to be honest, I couldn't get rid of this book fast enough. I just was ready to get rid of it. I didn't want to have it anymore. And that's sad. So, that was my review of The Last Empress by An Chi-min, and please subscribe to my channel, and there will be more book reviews on the way. Bye.